Time for sound design. In today's video, I'm gonna create another sampled instrument, and this time I'm gonna sample some guitar feedback. On some rock music at the end of the song, you hear kind of guitar feedback when they create feedback by holding the guitar by the amp, and the song kind of fades out and there's some kind of noise. So I'm gonna take a little bit of that and throw that into sampler and see if I can create some kind of ambient textural instrument from that. And the artist that I'm gonna sample is Limp. It's from their second album from 1999, and the song is called Rearranged. And at the end of the song, it's sort of an outro before there's another like interlude beat, there is this kind of guitar feedback. So it's kind of the echo of the voice, and then so that kind of feedback sound from the guitar, that's what I want to use, and see if I can pull out like a note from there and use that. So let's go to Ableton and start some sound design. I have loaded up a MIDI track with sampler, and I'm gonna drag in the sample. So I'm using sampler because it has the sustain mode forward backwards, so it's easier to create a seamless loop. The release time is on 50 milliseconds, so let's change the start and end points. So if I play the original pitch, that's the part I want, so let's zoom in. So it is a D sharp, and as you can tell from listening to a sample, but also visually here, you can see that the right channel is louder than the left. So I'm gonna isolate the right channel, and I'm gonna also put a low cut at 100 Hertz. Let's put on the sustain mode forward backwards and adjust the loop start points. Yeah, to something like this. Add some crossfade. So a bit more crossfade because it's not very smooth now, the loop. I'm actually changing the loop part. I'm going to take this bit as a bit earlier. It feels a bit more constant. So this is the part that actually takes most of the time, and it's kind of the tricky is which part to use and where to put the loop start and end points, and how much crossfade to use to create something that kind of works as a loop. It doesn't need to be smooth. There can be variation in dynamics in the loop, but something that's like pleasant enough to hear in a looped way. So I think this is a better part, maybe a bit less crossfade. And I want a bit more release, so I do 2.5 seconds and a little bit of attack, so 10 seconds attack time. So now let's tune it. So the root at D sharp, or maybe plus 12 detune. And the cool thing is now we can play it polyphonically. If you want. I mean, I don't know, it doesn't sound that good, but. All right, let's add some effects. So the first thing, of course, as always, a delay, not too long. Filter the output, do some delay spreading, maybe the feedback at 40. The other thing is I want to add some autopan to create a bit more stereo spread. And I'm also going to play with the filter in sampler. So I'm going to lower it, crank up the resonance a little bit, and use the filter envelope to control the filter. Maybe somewhere here. just a little bit of variation. So in the original pitch, it sounds like this. Actually, this is the original pitch, D sharp. An octave up doesn't sound that bad, actually. An octave down could also be. But maybe in the same octave that actually the sample is in is good. So let's put in some notes and see if we can create some kind of ambient vibe with this instrument. So maybe start with an F. Something like this, descending loop. Change a bit of velocity. Is this... Yeah, it's a 4-bar loop now. Change it to this. Yeah, and this is basically the instrument that I created. So I started with a tail of a rock song or a new metal song from Limp, the guitar feedback, and then throw that into sampler. And then with some simple sound design, you can create something that's very sort of noisy, ambient, but that can really work as a texture for a electronic track. So the next step to do is to group all this into an instrument rack. So I can save it to my library of sounds. So next time I want to create some music, I have an instrument that I created from this sample that is ready to go and that I can use that is one of my own sounds. If you're interested in sampled instruments and creating them from samples or from instruments, I have two sample libraries over on Gumroad. The link is in the description. They're free to download and free to use. So go check that out. They're all for Ableton. As always, keep making music. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.